Dear students, the definition of culture and its characteristic features that were explained in the last class have enabled us understand the concept culture in sociology. There are many more concepts relating to culture that have to be studied to get a full clarity of the intrinsic component of society called culture. The most important concepts are cultural lag and cultural relativism. First, I will explain to you cultural lag. There are two aspects of culture, namely the material culture and the non-material culture. The material culture consists of all tangible and physical substances of society. The non-material culture includes all the beliefs, values, and customs. The material aspects of culture are likely to change faster in the event of social change. Technology undergoes a rapid change in social and industrial development. People also welcome technological changes and advancements without any hesitation. The scientific inventions result in changes in the material culture, like buildings, automobiles, and transportation. People accept and adopt themselves to these technological changes very easily. On the other hand, the non-material culture is found to be either very slow in changing itself or it resists change itself. As a result of this difference in the pace of change, there is a lag between these two aspects of culture. While the material culture consisting of technology advances rapidly, the non-material culture lags behind, resulting in disruption in social order. The non-material culture consisting of belief system opposes change and wants to preserve the native culture. This creates a vast gap between the fast changing material culture and the conservative non-material culture. William Ogburn has coined the term cultural lag to refer to this gap. William Ogburn used the term cultural lag to describe the change that occurs unequally between the material culture, that is tangible objects, and the non-material culture, that is the ideas, beliefs, and values. The next one is cultural diffusion. Different forms of societies have developed different patterns of culture based on their historical and geographic background. In course of time, the people of different cultures have come into contact with each other. Under such conditions, there is exchange of cultural items, both artifacts and ideas, between the two cultures. Cultural elements spread and there is borrowing of these elements between the two societies. The cultural elements of one society get diffused into the other society. This is called cultural diffusion. The term diffusion means borrowing of cultural elements from another society. Kroeber considered diffusion as the main source of culture growth and social change. For example, the Western societies borrowed from India the art of yoga. On the other side, the music, food habits, and many novel ideologies have diffused into the Eastern culture. Students, we should also know something about the concepts called assimilation and acculturation. Due to technological advancements and high transportation facilities, there are more opportunity for two cultural groups to meet and interact. Under such circumstances, there could be borrowing of a few features by one culture from another culture, which is known as assimilation. But there are periods in which two cultures coming into contact with each other merge together in course of their interaction. Consequently, the identity of both the cultural groups is lost and a new form of culture emerges. This is known as acculturation. The term acculturation is widely accepted among American anthropologists as referring to those changes set in motion by the coming together of societies with different cultural traditions. It is merging of cultures as a result of prolonged contact. For example, the fourth generation of Indian family living in America will not have any identity of Indian culture. They are merged with American culture. Cultural modification of an individual group or people by adapting or borrowing traits from another culture, but at the same time retaining the original cultural values, is called as assimilation. And now I hope that you understand the difference between assimilation and acculturation. Now we pass on to the next concept called cultural pluralism. Cultural pluralism refers to the coexistence of several subcultures within a given society on equal terms. Indian culture is a good example for cultural pluralism. The predominant Hindu culture pervades the whole nation, but still many subcultural groups like rural culture, Sikh, Islamic, and Parsi traditions coexist in it. This is what Redfield and Yogendra Singh explain as the great tradition and the little tradition of India. All these cultures coexist without any drastic conflict between them. The next concept is cultural relativism. Individuals are born and brought up in a specific cultural background. When they come into contact with another culture that is entirely different from their own, they have to judge the other culture, setting aside personal beliefs and prejudices to understand another culture. He must develop the quality of understanding that culture through the eyes of the members of that culture and by their standards. We should develop the quality of judging the other culture not from the values of our own culture, but encourage a broad view to accept and respect the values of other cultures too. We should avoid judging cultural practices as good or bad, superior or inferior, making references to our own culture. For instance, the practice of fraternal polyandry prevailing among Toda tribes cannot be judged from the cultural value of monogamy in our society. The practice of polyandry among Todas had evolved from the practice of female infanticide and the scarcity of women population. Another example is that an American cannot criticize the religious practices of Indian society, like offering sacrifices or to perform aarti to God. They should learn to view it as unique to Indian culture. The next very important concept relating to culture is ethnocentrism. When people travel abroad, they have to adopt the cultural practices and accept the values of the new society. Under that context, they have a tendency to look down upon the practices of the new culture as inferior. But you see, students, each culture has its unique pattern of behavior, which seems to be alien to people from other cultural background. Therefore, the newcomer feels that this culture is quite unusual and absurd. For him, it is not natural like his own culture. Ethnocentrism is the feeling in which a person feels that his own culture is good and right, while the other cultural practices are bad and wrong. An example for ethnocentrism is making fun of tribal dressing pattern or their ritual ordinance. It is expected that sociologists should avoid ethnocentrism while studying social groups. The next concept is cultural reproduction. Cultural values are transmitted from generation to generation. Each generation hands over its culture to the next generation to follow its components. This mechanism by which continuity of cultural experiences is sustained across the time is known as cultural reproduction. The process of socialization and schooling are the mechanisms of cultural reproduction. Cultural reproduction takes place in a subtle manner by which the individual learns cultural elements in an informal way. So far, I have been explaining to you the different concepts that come under culture, and we have to understand one more term relating to culture. The term is civilization. It is an important concept in sociological studies. The concept of civilization is very closely associated with culture. The term civilization is derived from the Latin word civitas, that means city. Since cities emerged only in the later part of human life, civilization also developed relatively at a later period. The term civilization is used to refer to the attainments of man in his social life, which differentiates him from animal groups. Civilization refers to those devices and instruments by which nature is controlled. It includes technical and material equipments along with the technical knowledge man has developed. Social organizations like schools and banking systems are part of civilization, but they are external. There are some definitions that explain the term civilization. Kant used the term civilization to mean outward behavior of man. According to Gillen and Gillen, civilization is more complex and evolved from culture. Augman and Nemkov define civilization as the later phase of superorganic culture. For McKeever and Page, civilization is the whole apparatus of life. Although the terms culture and civilization are considered to be similar for layman's understanding, there is a vast difference between these two concepts in sociology. Culture and civilization represent two broad fields of human activity and experiences, but there are some significant differences between them. These are explained in the following passage. 1. Civilization has a precise standard of measurement, but not culture. The products of civilization can be measured quantitatively on grounds of efficiency. For example, aircraft is a better transportation than a car or a bullock cart, but this measurement cannot be done for cultural elements. Each cultural element is unique in its own way and holds good for that culture only. For example, religious beliefs cannot be quantified in terms of their utility. The second one, the product of civilization are more easily communicated than culture. The products of civilization are open to all. This knowledge can be passed on easily. For instance, new inventions like camera or television may be used and accepted by any ordinary man than a cultural value which is subject to criticism. For example, the ideas like soul or transmigration cannot be easily explained or accepted by people. The third one, civilization is always advancing, but not culture. Civilization always show an upward trend. There is no break in the social continuity. The knowledge, intelligence, and efficiency of every generation is added to civilization constantly. The progress of civilization is assured. For instance, advancements in the technology relating to the manufacturing of automobiles. But in the case of culture, advancement is not applicable. There may be modifications from one way to the other, but we cannot attribute it as advancement. For example, the philosophies of Vivekananda, Periyar, or Aristotle have to be accepted as ideologies, but not as commodities. Fourthly, civilization is borrowed without loss, but culture is not. People could borrow the products of civilization very easily. The technical know-how and devices can be easily borrowed and transferred. For instance, the intellectual properties could be easily registered and borrowed, but in the case of culture, the values can be diffused gradually only if it is suitable to that culture. The fifth point is, civilization is external, but culture is internal. Civilization can be presented as external and as a utilitarian product. Since civilization is a means, it satisfies human needs, but culture is very much internal. It refers to the intrinsic values and beliefs that occupy the soft feelings of mankind. McIver and Page have said that civilization is what we have and culture is what we are. The sixth point, culture reveals the nature of the society, but not civilization. The cultural qualities reveal the personality or the makeup of an individual. One can say that American culture is achievement oriented. The Indian culture views life as fatalistic, but in case of civilization, the intelligence and the technical aspects will not reveal the personality of the individual man. Although civilization and culture are two different entities, they are interdependent and interactive. Both are man-made. The environment of civilization can affect the thought process and morals of the society. Culture is the breeding ground for civilization. Okay, students, I am sure that now you are clear with the concepts culture and civilization, because this class consisted of explanations on cultural lag, cultural diffusion, assimilation, acculturation, cultural pluralism, cultural relativism, cultural reproduction, ethnocentrism, civilization and its definitions, and finally, the difference between culture and civilization. There are some questions to be answered. The first question is, explain cultural lag with an example. The second question, what is cultural diffusion? Third one, discuss the difference between culture and civilization. All right, students, in the next class, I will be explaining more and more concepts of sociological importance. Bye.